Good morning, Ellen Pete, and welcome to our 59th GNN show. Today, we have a special Valentine's Day show to celebrate that greeting card holiday that happens next Tuesday. We also will take a look at boys basketball senior night. GNN starts now. Hi, my name is Haley, and welcome to GNN. We wanted to have some fun with Valentine's Day, even if you have someone to celebrate with or not. Let's start by traveling down to the lower school to see what the young students love about this day.
Good morning, LMP. With everything going on in the world right now, we could all use a little love. Let's see what lower school students love most about Valentine's Day.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is because everybody gets to along and mostly plays together. My favorite part about the Valentine's Day is spending time and hugging my family and giving out Valentine's.
My favorite part about Valentine's Day is getting candy.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is that it's my mom's birthday and I can give her chocolates and goodies.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is to eat the sweets.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is that it's my dog's birthday because my dad got my dog on Valentine's Day to give to my mom.
My favorite part about Valentine's Day is going to the Valentine's Day dance with my dad and spending time with my family.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is to give out cards.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is we get to tell people how much we like them.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is like the goodie bags you get and the people who give them to you and passing yours out to people, and I like the candy.
The favorite thing about Valentine's Day is when you get presents and candy.
My favorite thing about Valentine's Day is giving my parents kisses and hugs.
Ever have a horrible date? Marco and Christian take our cameras around school to find out your most embarrassing or funny date stories.
Hello, LMP. Valentine's Day, a day of love and affection, is right around the corner. However, we decided to do a 180 and hear the other side of the story. What's your worst date?
One time for Valentine's Day, the guy that I was dating took me to see the movie Vantage Point, and he snorts a lot through the whole movie. All the little kids and adults were turning around and staring at us so that he would be quiet. And we didn't talk for 3 weeks.
I was dating this guy for a while, and he had a fairly traditional Mexican family. So it was during their family reunion. There was a lot of weird stuff, like his family was part of a mariachi band, and they were like drinking vodka while holding their babies and stuff like that. And the weirdest part was they brought a goat. You know, we're in the suburbs of Deltona, like really not... They just bring a goat into their backyard. Next thing I know, they've killed it, and it's buried in the ground, and they're cooking it. And overall, it was just a terrible experience.
Did you guys break up?
Like a year later.
There was this movie date, and this girl showed up, and all she did was throw up the whole time. Like, she went to the bathroom and didn't come out for like an hour. And I texted her asking where she was, so I just left.
All right, so my worst date was in college when I was playing basketball. I had one of the boys from the soccer team challenge me to a game of horse. So I thought, that's fine, no big deal, I'll win. And anyway, the stakes were that if I lost, I had to go on a date with his roommate. And so I wasn't worried about it, but he ended up beating me on a header. He threw the ball up and he headed it into the basket. And I was like, oh, shoot, I can't beat that. So he beat me at horse, so I had to go on a date with his British roommate, and we went to this little coffee shop, like one of those where they have stand-up comedy and like stuff in the corner, live band or something like that, in the middle of the day. So there was no live anything going on. It was just me and him and coffee, and that was about it. No food, just like, how's life? It was awful. It was bad.
Worst date, went to a movie theater with a girl. She tried playing footsies with me, and I thought she was just, like, kicking my feet, and so I was, like, kicking at hers before I knew what footsies was. It was just really awkward, but yeah.
Stay tuned for more GNN, including basketball highlights, but first, these messages, including Cupid, around our hallways.
Hi, I'm Mitchell Wigginton. Have you ever wondered what LMP students do after they graduate? Today, we interview alumni Casey Wright to find out what he's been up to over at Rollins College.
There's a lot of reasons why I wanted to start my own radio show. Number one had to be my influence here at GNN, which was a vital aspect of what I wanted to do in my life as far as career standpoint. Really, I went to the person at Rollins, and the communications guy, and said, I talked about broadcasting, and he said, well, would you want a radio show? And I said, I hadn't really thought about it. And, you know, once I just started doing it, I started to fall in love with it. And it wasn't easy at first. You know, the show started just as me. And then that's what the name is. You know, like I said, just as me, it's Just a Man in Sports. And from there, I just picked it up, inviting more people on the show. And I just started love doing it.
So basically why I got involved with Casey's radio show is, well, before it was a radio show, it was a podcast. And he approached me and asked me if I wanted to be on the podcast. And I said that was no problem. I loved talking about sports almost all the time. So then about a year and a few months ago, we transitioned over to a live show. And ever since then, he's just been putting in the hours.
How do you balance baseball, your radio show, and school all at once?
To the person who would hear the amount of stuff that I do, they say I'm crazy and that I can't really balance it. But the way I do it is the radio show is only Mondays from 10 to 12. I just don't schedule classes from that time. But it's not that time consuming in the day. You know, you go after practice, which would be about 4 o'clock, and then you do homework after when it ends at around 6. So you have time. You know, when you're college, you stay up pretty much all night doing homework.
What do you plan on doing after college is over?
Well, obviously I have a lot of different career paths that I could take with the field that I've got myself into. But as far as what I'd love to do is, you know, a dream of mine is to be a broadcaster in professional sports on a higher level, as far as Fox or CBS or NBC or something of that nature, and really go as far as I can with it. You know, obviously the all-in-all dream for a broadcaster is to do something like the World Series and get to that level. Like you said, you know, with the radio show, you don't really know as far as where I'm going, what will happen or where will I go, because you never know what a station's going to see in you. They could see the best broadcaster, I could see the best radio host. It's whatever calls to me the most, but that's definitely what I would want to do after college.
I'm Mitchell Wigginton with Nick Law, signing off for GNN.
The seniors of boys varsity basketball in G-Force recently celebrated their senior night with a 62-56 win over University. Let's take a look at the highlights.
The LMP basketball and cheer team celebrated their seniors last week with a great win over University. The senior members of G-Force included Haley Gray, Cameron Lucas, Alex Goldman, and Twan. And senior members of the basketball team included Matt Upper, Austin DeWitt, Jack Krim, Mitchell Wigginton, and Brady Benefield. The boys played a close game that came down to the very last minute and pulled away with a win. Congratulations to all the seniors, and we wish you luck in the future.
That's our show for today. Next week, we will have some more entertainment, including our own version of the dating game. Tune in next week, have a great day, and stay classy, LMP.